Okay, this is gonna sound absolutely insane, so I'm just gonna come right out and say it. Scientists at Lawrence Livermore are modeling organs, like live human organs, on chips. We're working on the brain, the heart, all the blood vessels that send blood all over your body, which is called your vasculature. And a recent development in this work is the successful modeling of one of the most mysterious and difficult to understand parts of your brain, the blood-brain barrier.
So the blood-brain barrier specifically is that barrier function between the brain space and the blood. So yes, this would be the blood-brain barrier itself. Yep, the endothelium.
Okay, hold up. Here's where we're at. The blood-brain barrier, or the BBB, if we're being efficient, is this thin sheet of tissue that separates your blood vessels from your brain tissue. The cells that make up a large part of the BBB are called endothelial cells, and they are joined together by something called tight junctions, which make it really hard for stuff to get through the BBB. These endothelial cells form a super tight monolayer, or a single layer of cells, between your brain and the rest of your body, and really, the rest of the world. The BBB essentially acts as a filter, protecting your brain from things that shouldn't get in, but at the same time, letting in things that your brain does need, like oxygen and nutrients. So your BBB itself has to be pretty smart. And this is what neuroscientists call highly selective, which means it's picky about what it lets through and what it doesn't. And this is really important because
we want to be able to understand how things make it across the barrier. So for example, in the case of cancer metastasis, there are certain cancers that really like to go to the brain space. One of those, for example, is breast cancer. It's going to migrate up into the brain space. And what's weird is that this monolayer is supposed to protect your brain, but for some reason it allows things to cross over. It then makes it harder because once that cancer is growing on the other side, if you want to administer drug treatments, it's really hard because, again, this barrier is going to prevent certain things from going across. In cases, especially with things like, treatment of certain type of mood disorders or something where you want to treat the brain space, you want to be able to make sure that things cross. From the defense side of things, you know, there are certain things that cross the blood-brain barrier that you don't want them to, and so how can you go back and sort of rescue back the function of what has crossed over?
So understanding more about the BBB and how it works is truly essential to lots of facets of science that involve the brain. But it's a tricky thing to study because it's hard to see in any great detail with the brain imaging tools we have at our disposal, and it's very difficult to tell what's going on at the cellular level in a BBB in a human body. So what do we do? The answer is invent a whole new technology that may change the way we study the brain.
So traditionally you have cells on a plate, and by putting these cells into this 3D environment and under flow, we're changing how those cells react and how they behave. Cells are sensitive to the environment that they're in, and changes to mechanical stress or surrounding cell types will change how they behave to each other and how they communicate.
So that little plastic square obviously doesn't look anything like a human, but it's a way of being able to test the drugs on something that isn't human but also isn't an animal. We already know that animal research isn't a great predictor of human health, so this is really a way to sort of bridge that gap, because how can you get close to humans without actually trying it on humans first and do sort of all of the exploratory stuff before you do it on human patients?
So this tiny, seemingly simple device takes us from cells in a 2D environment where they're not necessarily behaving anywhere close to how they would in a 3D environment, like in your body, and brings us into a 3D space where we can see how these cells would behave in more true-to-life environments, how they react when we make liquid flow past them, just like we would see in your actual blood-brain barrier. But cells are a tricky business because, you know, they're alive. Like, you can't just plop them down and leave them alone.
I mean, that's a bioengineering problem, right? And Those two disciplines on their own are very hard. So biology is incredibly hard. Keeping things alive, it's like having a pet, right? Like, these are devices that we make, and then we have to continue to take care of them. In our case, our devices, the minimum that we would run a device would be a week, but we've run them up to 4 weeks of culture. So that's 4 weeks of us having to feed something and take care of and make sure that it's okay. And so that's the biology part of it. And then engineering comes with all its challenges, right? Like, how do you build a system in a way that's repeatable and gives you what you want? But then we have the third challenge, which is bringing those things together.
So how do we know that a device like this is anywhere close to modeling something like how the BBB really is? How do we know that it works? Well, we can see it.
That monolayer that formed looks something like this. So this is the endothelial cells, and they've been stained for what is called actin. And that's what's visible in green. And then the nuclei, which is kind of the brain of a cell, is in blue. So wherever there's a blue dot, there's a single cell. And then the green is the body of the cell. And so you can see that it kind of spreads across where the cells are kind of connecting to one another.
I'm sorry, I just have to take a minute to point out here that what we're looking at are actual cells cultured inside this novel device, and they formed these tight junctions that define the blood-brain barrier, and we can see it all. Like, this is not a simulation or a rendering, these are the real cells. What? I just think it's so crazy that science lets us do that. But it's not all about the pretty pictures, because Monica and her team do have to work really hard to coach these cells into behaving in this specific way. Like, to get them to hold hands super tightly like they do in your actual BBB, they need to be crowded into a small space in a certain way and fed certain signals that tell them to glue together like this. And here's where it gets even more amazing. The BBB is not the only human system that Livermore scientists are modeling on a chip. They're also modeling systems like the central nervous system, or your CNS, which is the rest of your brain and your spinal cord. So if you put these two systems together, the CNS and the BBB, we could have a highly detailed and accurate model of the way your brain cells behave. And with the BBB, which is a huge deal because lots of people leave that out of brain models because, well, it's hard. And eventually, we could have a whole model of a human body on a chip in 3D with live human cells.
I mean, yes, that's the goal, to be able to piece all these organs together and be able to understand, okay, here's a drug that I've given you that treats your liver. Is it going to have any side effects to other parts of your organs? Because this is really kind of looking at one piece of it, you know, how things cross the blood-brain barrier. But those drugs are obviously going to have other effects because they're systemically delivered, so they're not just going to go to one space, they'll go to other spaces. So the end goal for all of these devices is to integrate them to create sort of a human model. What really resonates with me is the impact that these devices can have. And then as a bioengineer, I really like playing in that space. As hard as it is, I really kind of enjoy that challenge because it's a really unique challenge when you're trying to make both pieces work. So for me, that's the part that makes me excited.
If you want even more videos like this on research and technology that seem like science fiction, then subscribe to this channel and check out our whole Inside the Lab playlist. Let us know what else you want to learn about this technology or others like it down in the comments below. And as always, thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time.